Hey, what's good, guys? This is Chris from WearTesters.com. Welcome back to the official WearTesters.com YouTube channel. Today, we're taking a detailed look and review of these potential bad boys right here. This is Donovan Mitchell's first signature sneaker, the Adidas Dawn Issue 1. So first things first, I'm stoked to get these in hands. Not only did Adidas send a pair, big thank you to Adidas Basketball, by the way, or Adidas Hoops, but I also bought a pair in a half a size down from Jimmy Jazz, because for whatever reason, they put them out way early, so I bought them. The trick is, when you buy something from a retailer early, sometimes they can cancel your order, so pay for one day shipping, because then they rush the order out, and they're like, hey, we gotta get this out, before they actually double check whether or not they were supposed to be selling them. Small tip, you do pay a little bit more, but you actually get your shoe instead of having to deal with a potential canceled order. Now, I did buy these in a half a size down because I was unsure about Adidas' sizing, per usual. And Adidas sent me my true size, so that's what I would go with. I tried them both on lengthwise. They both feel very similar, but it's the midfoot tightness. Like, the smaller size is way too tight. Like, it feels like my foot is cramping. Now, I could probably wear them, break them in, all that stuff, but this one, after I tried them on and laced them up, they just felt like the best option for me, so I'm going to go with my true size. These guys right here, we're going to be giving away. We have a bunch of stuff to give away. We're gonna be doing it on a brand new platform coming soon. There's this thing called Discord. A lot of you guys probably already know about it and use it. I don't, because I'm just not in the know apparently, but Discord is a thing. And we're gonna use that platform as kind of like a Patreon. We're not gonna charge a lot of money or anything because I want it to be strictly kind of like donation based. It's not like anything crazy. I get emails and messages and DMs and stuff like that all the time from people being like, yo, like, how can we help you guys out? Because believe it or not, we do buy, like, these I bought, didn't know that these were coming, so that was cool. But we buy like 99% of the products that you see here on the channel, and I know that's a lot of sneakers. I get it. I spend the money on it. It's crazy. So a lot of people actually ask, like, how can they help out and stuff like that, and I always usually decline because I don't want to take anybody's money. But so many people have asked that I'm just like, man, maybe we should, but I want to make sure that they actually, I wouldn't say get their money's worth, but you know what I mean? Like, I just want to make sure that, like, if you're going to be donating or whatever, that you're actually, like, getting something in return. So one of those things is going to be a lots of giveaways. We got a lot of stuff. I normally used to sell my old shoes for cheap. Instead, we're going to use that platform. We're just going to be giving them away to people. Whether they're your size or not, doesn't matter. You can enter and all that stuff. You can gift them to someone or whatever. If you got a little brother, a dad, whomever that possibly wears my size, you could do that. We also have a bunch of other random sizes, so we'll be giving those things away. On top of that, you'll also be getting, like, pretty much like instant access to myself and any other Wear Testers team members. So you can talk to me about anything that you'd like, or you can just pick my brain about performance. Now, that platform's not available, so don't ask when it's going to be available, because I actually don't know. It's going to be sooner than later, maybe, maybe not. But once it is live, we will give you guys an update, both here on the channel, on the website, as well as our social media channels. Now, as far as these guys go, they remind me a lot of the Adidas Pro Vision. The overall feel for me on these things, it feels very similar, where it does have bounce cushion. The midsole is full on bounce. You can really feel it in the heel. In the forefoot, it feels pretty, like, subdued and everything. It doesn't feel as plush as maybe something like the Dame 5. I also wouldn't say that it's as low feeling or as low profile feeling as something like the Dame 4. It's somewhere kind of in the middle. So still pretty good. It's just not anything super crazy. And for $100, I guess that's cool. $100, by the way, is a great price point, especially like a great entry price point for a signature shoe. On top of that, these are official collaboration or in official collaboration with Marvel Comics. And it's not just with this colorway right here. It's actually every colorway is going to be based on a Marvel Comics hero or villain within the Spider-Man universe, which I think is f***ing awesome. That was one of the things where I was like, really? Because when they unveiled the stuff, which we posted not too long ago on WearTesters.com, they said that this was obviously the classic, you know, red and blue suit. They have this black and pink one that's made after Venom, so you can see the teeth in the back. The black and green one is the newer style kind of stealth suit that you'll see in some of the more modern comics. And then you have the Iron Spider suit as well. Not the Iron Spider suit from the Marvel movies, the real Iron Spider suit from the Marvel comics. So that pretty much takes care of my first impression or first thoughts on the cushion. The traction right here is what Adidas has been going with pretty much since last year, which is nothing but herringbone. Great move. The only thing is, like the Harden Volume 3s, these guys right here, they are very tight. If you play on a super dusty floor, that's going to be kind of a downside. Make sure that you keep up them wipes though. You'll be good. The rubber feels nice and durable though. It feels nice and sturdy. The herringbone is kind of interesting too. It's not the traditional kind of like sharp look. Everything on these guys is very Spider-Man like. So if you look at them, it looks like each peak is kind of curved. So it's like a spider web all the way around. Super small detail, but I think it's really cool. I said this before, if you're telling stories, man, you better make sure that that traction works. And this right here, that's the way to do it, man. Herringbone, but slightly tweaked just to be like, it's a web. Something that I think is weird though, is Adidas's modern shoes, like from like the Next Level to the Hardens, is they got these weird like divots in all of the outsoles. And at first, when I first started seeing them, I was just like, is that a manufacturing issue? But it's on every pair, even the ones that I see in stores. And I don't understand why. This shoe, like if you feel it, there's like a little divot here, there's one here, but then it's also stable at the same time. So I'm wondering if that's for compression of the midsole. Maybe it's to help give you that bouncier feeling without giving you a real premium cushion and all that stuff, because all of their shoes are kind of affordable. I'm not really sure. They don't feel weird though. That's the weird thing, because at first I thought that they were like warped soles. And normally when you wear a shoe with a warped sole, you can feel it. Like it literally feels like it's sloped or edged out and all that stuff. These don't feel like that. They feel like normal shoes. So I thought it was really strange. It's on every single pair. You let me know what you think, because that's one of those things where it's not official. Like the information on that, nobody has straight up said from Adidas, like this is the reason for this. So it's all up to speculation. Feel free to let me know what your speculative thoughts are on those little divots on the bottom of all these shoes. Now the materials are nothing special. It's just a basic textile. And I think that it's going to work fine. It feels rugged on top of that, so it doesn't feel like it's going to fray and rip and all that stuff. It also feels backed by something, especially right here in the forefoot. The rest of it's just like a lightweight, airy mesh. You got that really kind of like big, puffy, exaggerated heel, the collar and all that stuff. Very similar to a lot of their current modern shoes right now. They have very similar design language throughout the entire line. So they kind of have this shape that you can just see and you're like, yeah, that's an Adidas shoe. Now inside of the tongue area, it's quilted, but not only that, they've done that web pattern once again. So they've added a feature in the shoe that also tells a story that really does make sense. You can also see that poking through on the front right there. You got the web behind the spider logo. You have that official Marvel branding right there and lots of padding and sculpting right here on the heel and interior collar area. There's lots of points of little pillows, so they're gonna really cup your ankle. And that area feels great on foot, especially when you like yank up the laces even tighter. And I love that there's this additional one right in the back there, so you can really get that draw that I was talking about in the Curry 303. There's points where the laces really are like a guide to lockdown. So, you know, the forefoot locks this area, the midfoot locks that area, and then the ankle is normally supposed to lock in this area and draw it into the back. That's what those lace loops are for. And again, they added one way back there just in case this isn't enough. So I think that that's awesome. And then you got this extra little panel right there. It's not completely independent, it's sewn on, but it's supposed to be for additional kind of like midfoot lockdown and everything, or reinforcement. And then right beneath that is this little rubber piece. And I think that that's the weirdest part of the shoe, actually. It blends right in, so it's not like jarring or anything. I just think it's strange to have that there, because, you know, the midsole is exaggerated and that really does cup your foot. So having rubber there as extra reinforcement, I just think is like strange. Not bad, just strange. Speaking of all of that exaggeration, these are just, they're pretty wide, man. Like these are crazy. So I think stability is going to be on point. Mobility though, that's something that I'm kind of like curious about. I'm wondering if it's going to feel a little like awkward or maybe a little bit clunky, but we'll have to wait and see. And that pretty much takes care of it for these guys. They are supposed to be releasing on adidas.com on the 1st. Retail is going to be $100, and then they're supposed to hit the actual retailers on July 5th, so a couple days later, which is again why, like with the Jimmy Jazz thing, check out now before like they get caught, because then you can just grab your shoe before anyone else releases it and all that stuff. You don't even have to wait till the 1st. I don't know if they're still on there, by the way, but I will leave a link in the description box just in case. You think that's bad?
Adidas probably saw your post already and is like, Jimmy Jazz!
Maybe, I don't know. It's possible. But, you know, like, it's just one of those things. I don't think that it's our fault or our problem that a retailer messes up. That's just to our benefit. If you want to buy the shoe early, which who wouldn't, and you don't have to go on eBay and pay reseller prices, you can buy it for retail. It's as simple as that. I do think that it was smart of Adidas, though, to do that, what I call a Nike move, where it's you drop a shoe early, and they do it exclusively through their own channel, their own distribution. So they, what I call direct, so it's from brand to consumer instead of from brand to retailer to consumer. That is, I just think it's smart because it gives them more money. The bad side though is that these things, these moves that these brands are doing, selling direct to consumers, are slowly killing retail. So on one hand, it's good for the business or the brand to maintain its status and all that stuff and to kind of grow. But again, it's also going to be killing the retailers, which I think is a bummer, because they won't last long, especially when you have places like Amazon or these apps that are already heavy hitters towards open doors. It is what it is. But thank you so much for watching. Thanks for all the support. Again, thank you to Adidas for sending these out. I greatly appreciate it. Let me know what you guys think about these down below in the comment section. It feels like these and the Freak Ones are like the two, at least for the summer, they're like the two most anticipated sneakers so far this year, I feel. If there's another one though, let me know down below in the comment section, because there's so many sneakers coming out this year that I cannot keep up. And that's my job, is to like write news. And so I do it and then I forget about it because I'm on to the next one. Thank you so much once again. And until next time, guys. Have a good one. You look mad corny though.
No. So we're putting out a video probably this weekend, and in it we touched on the fact that he doesn't like vlogging, but today was a day that I wish we did, just so I could have captured your face when I came out into our workspace and was like, hey, I'm ready.
What did I do? I
just your face instantly went to,
I was just like, yo, you're mad corny right now. Like, what is this? Like, this...
This is from my Halloween costume 2 years ago, and I like a good reason to wear it.
It's funny, though. I'm not hating. You know, it was just one of those, like, what a cornball.
That's what but, I am.
Yeah, but it's fine. Honestly, like, I would have done it, too.
I'm surprised you didn't.
Do I even have I have lots of Spider-Man shirts. I don't think I have one, like, a
costume. He used to have a really cool one when we first started dating.
Dude.
It was, like, a movie replica.
Yeah, it was the first Spider-Man movie, the Raimi one, the Raimi trilogy. But what did he call himself? The Human Spider?
Yeah.
Right? And then he was like, the Human Spider? The Amazing Spider-Man.
My name's the Human Spider.
So like that wrestling shirt, I had the replica of that and it was sick. I used to get compliments on that all the time when I'd wear it out. And people would be like, yo, where'd you get that?
He was wearing it the first time my dad met him, and my dad still talks about it to this day. Like, who is this nerd my daughter's dating?
You safe with me, sir?